गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज अर्लियर आई हैड स्टार्टेड रीडर एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर वाज द लास्ट लीफ। सम पार्ट ऑफ दैट लेसन टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू इट। स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव स्टडीड हाउ एंड जांसी बोथ वर क्लोज फ्रेंड्स, वर लिविंग इन द सेम रूम on the third floor of a house. You have studied how Jhansi was suffering from him and she had made up her mind that she would die if the last leaf of that ivy creeper on the brick wall would fall. Students, you have also studied how Sue had consoled Jhansi that she would not die as the doctor had told that she would get well, but Jhansi did not listen to it. She decided, she had made up her mind that she would die when the last leaf of that ivy plant would fall. Now open your book, all of you, and see page number 45, ever side. See, six whispered Jhansi, they are falling faster now. 3 days ago there were almost 100 leaves, there are only 5 left now. You have studied this line, students. As on that ivy creeper, before 3 days, 100 leaves were there, and Jhansi is now telling to her friend Sue that before 3 days, 100 leaves were there, but now only 6 leaves were left. It is autumn, said Sue, and the leaves will fall. Then Sue said that it was autumn season and all the leaves would fall. When the last leaf falls, I will die, said Jhansi with finality. I have known this for the last 3 days. Students, but the Jhansi reminded Sue that if the last leaf of that ivy plant, ivy creeper will fall, she would die. Oh, that's nonsense, replied Sue. But Sue consoled her and said that thinking this type of it is a nonsense thing, it is useless thing. What old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? The doctor is confident that you will get better. Students, Sue reminded Jhansi that the doctor had told that she would recover, but why she was so hopeless? Jhansi did not say anything. Sue went and brought her a bowl of soup. And then Sue had gone and brought a bowl of soup for Jhansi. I don't want any soup, said Jhansi. I am not hungry. Now there are only 4 leaves left. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. It gets dark, then I will sleep forever. But as Jhansi had made up her mind, she was counting the leaves of that ivy creeper. And at that time only 4 were left, and she was saying that if the last leaf fell, she would die. Yes. So now Sue sat on Jhansi's bed, kissed her, and said, "I am going to die. I cannot draw the curtain, for I need the light. I want to finish the painting and get some money for." At that time, I consoled her and said that she would get well, and she also told that as she was going to paint and for getting some money for them. Please my dear friend, she begged Jhansi, promise not to paint. And then Sue said to Jhansi not to look out through the window until she was painting. All right, said Jhansi, finish your painting soon, for I want to. I have to die, so let me go away peacefully like one of those poor tired leaves. As you see that Jhansi told Sue that if the last leaf fell, she would die, and she was counting it very attentively. Try to sleep, said Sue. I have to paint an old miner. I will call Brahman up to be my model. Now Sue advised her friend Jhansi to sleep peacefully, and she said that she would call Brahman, who was the good painter, and she said that she would be the model for that. So rushed down. Brahman lived on the ground floor. Brahman was also living in the same house, but he was living on the first floor. Su had gone to call him. He was a 60-year-old painter. His lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece. Brahman was also a good painter, and he was 60 years old. He wanted to make a masterpiece. Masterpiece means best work. He wanted to paint a masterpiece that should be the best work in his life. It was his dream. That had remained a dream. So Sue poured out her worries to Brahman. She told him how Jhansi was convinced that she would die when the last leaf fell. Convinced means persuaded. Sue told the idea of Jhansi that she had made up her mind that she would die if the last of that ivy creeper fell. "Is she stupid?" asked Brahman. But the Brahman said, "If Jhansi had been stupid, why did she say so? "Is she stupid?" asked Brahman. "How can she be so foolish? She is running a high temperature," complained Sue. Sue said that she was suffering from temperature fever. "She refuses to eat or drink, and that worries me a lot." And Jhansi did not take water and food, so Sue was worried. "I will come with you and see Jhansi," Brahman said. Brahman was agreed to go with Sue to see the condition of Jhansi. They tiptoed into the room. Tiptoed means walk quietly and carefully. Both Brahman and Sue walked very quietly and silently, carefully. They tiptoed into the room. Jhansi was sleeping. Sue drew the curtain together and they went to the next room. She peeped out through the window. Peeped out means looked out. Jhansi looked out and saw that outside what she had seen. Let's see. There was only one leaf on the creeper. Jhansi found that there was only one leaf on the ivy creeper. It was raining heavily and an icy cold wind was blowing. At that time it was raining heavily and the icy cold wind was blowing. It seemed as though the leaf would fall any minute now. Brahman did not say a word. He went back to his room. Now Sue told Brahman that any time that last leaf would fall. She thought that the last leaf would fall, and she told this thing to Brahman. So Brahman was silent and he returned back. He went to his room and he said nothing. Jhansi woke up next morning in a feeble voice. Feeble voice? Feeble means low voice, weak voice. Next morning, Jhansi woke up from bed and in low voice, she said to her friend Jhansi. She asked, Jhansi woke up next morning in a feeble voice. She asked Sue to draw the curtain. And when Jhansi woke up from her bed and in feeble voice, in low voice, she asked her friend Sue to draw the curtain. Sue was nervous. She drew back the curtain very reluctantly. Reluctantly means unwillingly. When Jhansi told Jhansi advised Sue to draw the curtain as she wanted to see the last leaf of that ivy plant, whether it had fallen or it remained. So Sue was reluctantly unwillingly she drew the curtain. "Oh," she exclaimed as she looked at the vine creeper. "Look, there is still one leaf on the creeper." And when she saw that it was a leaf, one leaf was left on that creeper. "It looks quite green and healthy in spite of the storm and the fierce winds. It did not fall." And she said that in that strong wind, fierce wind, strong and ferocious wind, in strong wind also that leaf remained in that on that plant and it did not fall. Students, in this way we have studied today that Jhansi was suffering from pneumonia and she had made up her mind that she would die if the last leaf of that ivy creeper fell. But her friend Sue consoled her and reminded her that the doctor had told that she would get well. But Jhansi did not follow that, did not listen to it, and she was counting the leaves, and at last 4 leaves were left at last. And at that night the strong wind was blowing, icy wind was blowing, any time the last leaf might fall. So Sue said that she would go to call Brahman, who was a 60 years old painter, and she said that he would be the model for her. And Brahman came and listened whatever Sue had said about Jhansi, and he returned to his house. And next day, when the curtain was drawn by Sue, she found that the last leaf remained there on that ivy creeper. Further, what happened is that I will teach you next day. Thank you.